Hello everyone, I am Bob and this is the Home Bitcoin Immersion Mining Channel. In this design series episode, we're going to cover how to add Bitcoin heating to a house without using an extra dry cooler to cool the miners. So with that, let's get started. Okay, in my first home heating with Bitcoin episode, I outlined the four different setups for heating your house with Bitcoin. And those are either using forced air or hydronic or hot water heat to heat your house, and either keeping your miners on all the time or turning your miners on only when heat is needed. In the first two design episodes, I covered the two options for keeping miners on all the time and how to integrate that heat into both types of home heating. I've got a link above to the design playlist where you can find these episodes and all of the other episodes covering how to build a home Bitcoin immersion mining system. But in this episode, I'm going to cover the final two options of heating a home with Bitcoin, using either forced air or hydronic heating and only turning the miners on when heat is needed. Now, on one hand, only running miners when you need the heat is not that much different than running miners on all the time. The methods and techniques used to modify a home heating system to accept Bitcoin heat are the same. But on the other hand, there are two major differences between keeping miners on all the time and only using them when heat is needed. And the first and most obvious difference is that a method of turning the mining system on and off is needed. This includes turning on and off both the miners and the pumps used to circulate the fluid cooling the miners. Now, in a past episode, I covered how to integrate a control system with mining setups. I covered a bunch of different technologies that can be used to develop these systems. These included programmable logic controllers, small computing systems such as Arduino or Raspberry Pi, running home automation software like Home Assistant, and simple relay or analog circuits. In that episode, the control system design was focused on safety, with miner and pump controls designed to be manually turned on but automatically turned off if parts of the system malfunctioned. The basics of that control system design can easily be extended to automatically turn on and off miners and pumps according to home heating needs. All that is needed is a connection to a home thermostat and a little additional logic, code, or circuitry. Now, just like in that episode, I'm not going to get into the details of designing these electronic or software systems. There's just too many different types of technologies and different ways to get this done. But there are some great sources of information and know-how out there to help you figure out those details in your setup. Folks in home Bitcoin mining communities have been putting together home heating systems for quite a while now. I've added some links below, and if you have any additional links or contacts, send them my way and I'll add them to the list. Now, although I'm not going to get into the details here, I can point out some of the challenges to making this work. First, with an immersion system, there are going to be delays in getting everything up and running. Bitcoin miners will take a while to start up, connect to the mining pool, and start hashing at full power. For example, for a typical S19 miner, this startup process will take around 3 minutes. This is not a huge deal, and you might want to use that delay in the timing of starting up your fluid pumps. But second, and more importantly, the miner cooling fluid will take some time to heat up. Now, the time needed to heat up will be highly dependent on how the system is built. The more fluid held in the miner tank, the longer it will take for that fluid to heat up, and the efficiency of heat transfer between the mining system and the home heating system will also affect how quickly everything comes up to temperature. Now, as long as the immersion system doesn't have a ridiculously large miner tank, this also shouldn't be a huge problem. Maybe it will take 10 to 30 minutes to start heating your home, and that can be handled by simply setting the thermostat set point a little higher to turn on the Bitcoin home heating a little earlier. So with the difference in controlling mining systems covered, the other significant difference between keeping your miners on all the time or only powering them up when you need that heat is an important design consideration when designing the heat exchangers, passing heat from your miners to your home. In an immersion system designed to run the miners all the time, there is a dry cooler in series with the home heating heat exchanger. This dry cooler has the capacity to fully cool the miners when the heat isn't being used, and the dry cooler also has the added benefit of backing up the home heating heat exchanger. If the home heating heat exchanger doesn't pull enough heat out of the cooling fluid, that dry cooler will remove the remaining heat. This will always ensure the cooling fluid returning to the miners will be cool enough to prevent the miners from overheating. Now, one of the advantages of only running the miners when heat is needed is the system can be designed not to have a backup dry cooler. The system can be designed to dump all of the heat into the house, fully cooling the fluid. Now, if this design is chosen, it's really important to select the right size of home heating heat exchanger. If the heat exchanger is undersized, the miners will start to heat up, and if left running long enough, they will overheat. Instead, it's a good idea to calculate or estimate how much heat you can deliver from your miners to your house and then use a slightly larger heat exchanger. This will ensure that the fluid returning to the miners is completely cooled and will avoid overheating the miners. Now, it is possible to add a dry cooler or other backup heat dissipation system to ensure the fluid is fully cooled before returning to the miners, but that's a lot of extra hardware to add, and that would eliminate one of the key advantages of only running miners when heat is needed. Okay, so that's all I have for this episode. In the next episode, I'm going to get back into my build and show you how I've built the ultimate quiet dry cooler. Like and subscribe so you won't miss any new episodes coming your way, and so with that, bye.